Okay, so there are two matches happening at the same time right now. Maybe we go back and forth, like, oh guys, holy shit, Israel is about to go nuts. Oh, but Sweden, oh, oh no, it's gonna switch again. It's gonna switch again. Yikes. Wait, can they do it?
They don't remember it.
Oh man, this ending is gonna be so close.
Oh, holy shit, holy shit. I really thought it was gonna go back right at the end, man. That final burst. 5,000 points difference. Oh no, Israel missed. No way. I was really believing hard for a moment.
Just send this away to Japan, especially with caution missing as well. That will definitely.
It's still relatively close, but yeah, it's over.
Stayed close until.
It's now 1FC versus 3, and a very good supporting combo. So definitely a good pick, but you know, until the very end, that was actually quite close. It wasn't a dominant win or anything. Only 300k. What the fuck is Dectopia Haga? You know, no. That's a wild take. Dectopia the man actually missed. Oh well. Still a very good score. Still above 3 million, but wasn't the third way FC. Very nice, man. Very nice. That was not close at all. 1 million difference, what are you gonna do? Oh my god, this is gonna switch over to Japan at the last moment, isn't it?
Mr. Potato holding this FC, if he does so, it does look like Israel will be able to hold on, backed by that chip combo.
Guys, holy shit. Okay, no, I think they've done it.
Israel just solidified the point with that.
Oh, yes. Yes, yes. I didn't realize Dictopia missed. Let's fucking go, Israel. Let's fucking go. Perfect.
Those butt sliders.
Yeah, I don't even care about the brakes. Very nice. Very nice. We are officially above the 3 million mark. Pretty good act too. Like, they weren't struggling at all.
We just have to.
That's a GG. GG, well played. Well done, Japan. Israel,
wait,
I still love you guys. You may be out of the tournament, but in my heart, Israel number one. Next year, you got it. Next year, top five guaranteed. I'm betting on it.
No change then. It's still with Finland. The two FCs, Freet and Amasetic, rock solid with that accuracy. No problems at all.
Sweden had the chance with the break from Zeppe, but the trade from Darion just instantly guaranteed the point for Finland. And look at Amasetic and Freeze, both FCing with a high 98 and a 99%. Almost 4 million score.
Yeah, advantage Sweden, final drop here. Everyone has to hold. Katzex with the break there.
Amasetic does as well. Wait a minute. There's only single taps left?
There's not much left at all. It might not be enough.
And it's not. Finland clutching out that Nomad 2 by just around 40,000. That was extremely close at the end for what seemed like a very Finland favored pick at the start. It looks like at the end of the day, it is going to be Finland on this alt map. The combos from Sweden all dropping, and the massive combos built up by Isaac, Amasetic, and Breeze. It looks like Finland is going to decisively take this Nordic matchup by the score of 5-1.
Finland have earned their bragging rights in this one, and they've won it in style. Really strong win and a really strong last point here on this alt map.
I don't think there's enough time for Mexico to pass them.
This is doable.
Even if they lost all the big combos.
This is doable. Every single player with an FC on Mexico right now has another 150.
Unless, wait.
And Wolfie is going to make up the difference.
Unless... Oh, no. Shit. Dude.
Oh, my God.
If only the map was 10 seconds longer. Wow. That was very unexpected. That went south very quickly for Thailand. You know, I thought this was going to be closer. I really did. But Thailand, they went in. And they won, fair and square. Not much to say there. This is also the loser's bracket, so now Mexico is officially out of the OSU World Cup. Damn. What a way to end it.
That kind of opens the door. Rektigod is still holding enough combo that I believe this lead should stay intact, because Demonico only has about 130k maybe of score left to go. And the lead is 200,000. I believe this is safe for the United States, thanks to the Rektigod backing score. But that let it get a little closer than it would have otherwise.
Ultimately, though, it will be a early break point for Team United States. Going to get on the board 1-0 against Singapore, going into their own first pick. Yeah, Sawada blundering a little bit on that slower part there. It's okay, I'm still proud of you. still two FCs, though, on Rektigod and Utami. Matched up against the one FC from Demonicle. Demonicle is putting up the performance that you want to see from him in this matchup, but unfortunately, the team performance from the USA is here this week. Look at this score lead. Over a million score on this one, or just about a million.
Now that's going to end up being a USA breakpoint, 968,000 points, the margin of victory for them.
As we mentioned, the United States is back.
People keep asking me if I'm back. I've had some time to think about it, and yeah, I'm thinking I'm back. The United States came to play. They're not messing around in this match one bit. Never let their foot off the gas pedal, and that is a quick 5-0 sweep. USA putting up another great score, 3.6 million with
hard times and coming back to this if they wanted to, but it would require a break from South Korea, which we are not seeing. Kind of extra excited to see the performances from these teams today. It is very infrequently that I am awake at the times of these matches, let alone get to cast them. So it's kind of exciting to see some of these players who, you know, you kind of see too often in here. Lolol235 gonna find a break towards the ending, unfortunately, leaving the only FC on China. Zayson could miss here. He's got lower accuracy. Fia does as well. Goodness, it's a hard pattern at the ending here. It's a slider.
Slider.
Oh, it's gonna be close, but I think Zayson might have it into these last few bursts right here. It doesn't matter if Fia holds the FC. The supporting combo on Parisia is just far too high, and it ends up being a 220,000 score lead for South Korea. You know, over the past couple of months, we have kind of come to expect a certain level of performance from Karcher, given the recent tournament plays that we have seen, and very much living up to that fact right now with this eminent Hard Rock FC coming in towards the ending here. Also with Amamiya Kokoro, gonna be pretty happy about that FC as well, the big cursor spin at the ending, and that is a almost 3.6 million team score from South Korea on a difficult map. With an over mod as well. 300,000 score of damage done so far, and there's about an eighth of the map to go. As long as... Oh, okay. Well, maybe I should stop talking, because this is actually winnable now for Crystal.
Well, Crystal only has about 200k score left, so I don't think they'll swing over the 200k.
Oh, the break from the game is not going to help. Yeah, you are right. It looked closer than it was, unfortunately. And that break from David is not going to do them any favors as well. That was a lot of lost score there. Karcher with a 700 combo to finish it as well.
The only break here is going to be from David. So still three FCs on the South Korean side are going to end up securing this map and match for the South Korean roster.
That was, you know, I want to give credit where credit is due. China had some very good maps there. And I mean, that's a 3.2 million team score for China. That's really good. But what South Korea just did in this match is what I would consider exceptional.
The advantage might be on the side of New Zealand if they can maintain, because of the accuracy on the side of Iron Bill. His score is going to be quite low. If Short Potato can maintain this combo, maybe a break from Catburger to the hope, but... Oh, that will do it.
Slow slider.
maybe if it caught everyone on the side of Denmark. Oh god, that it could come down to it.
Yeah, this ending.
Catburger is freaking the ending. So is Yoon and Zuma, but it's not going to be enough. Catburger holding off the side of New Zealand. An assist from Pole there. Zizis finds another break. We're going to have to see another break if you're a New Zealand fan right now, because Pole and Vil are shredding. Saiku finding that break. It's disaster.
Oh, it's all Pola and Vil.
And they'd have to break about now because look at them. They're going to close this. Oh my god, that was too close
from them.
That was extremely close. Zuma finding his FC finally. Oh, Zuma finding a break.
Oh wait.
There's chance Denmark. They all see the break. They all have to FC, and it's on Yoon and Saiki. Yoon's been looking really comfortable though. He's not one to miss on a map like this.
How fast it's going over? It's over. It's flicking already.
Oh my god, it's gone. That was so fast. That was literally an instant. Pixie moves act really holding them back on this map, and Holy Makapoy and Vil, they got through all the streams, and all that matters is that you hit them. You don't have to necessarily get SS ACK on those bursts. As proven, Marco and Vil were falling behind the spacing on this map. Last Nomad 2 was such a stamina-focused map, but this one really does push both the stamina and the aim, the flow aim, as it's just so spaced. No one really stepping up to get a really outlying score. It was kind of just a better team average on the side of Denmark, and that's just what it takes. And they will be advancing to that next match. As New Zealand will be taking their departure from this OWC.
Yeah, there's a lot of 99 going on, but that's from both sides as well. You know, you've got Setona Diamond and Natanum as well. Lacrease dropping in Jordan LR7 with MREC breaking. These are very, very unexpected misses from both sides.
I think they're fine. I don't think there's enough time.
It's definitely looking deep enough, but if Suffix and Dummy do happen to drop, there is a chance for Romania.
Yeah, my god, that's almost four away from Australia, though. 4.2 million. That's a solid way to start your match. Unless there's another break happening right about now on the side of Australia, there's not really much to miss on. They have a little bit of a cushion. Even though Romania kind of has a small combo advantage, there's not much really remaining in the map. It's just extremely simple patterning. Australia, again, it was pretty close, but taking Romania's first point here.
And that will be all said and done for this map. Eternum does end up falling against Milo Milkshake, Dummy, and Emmerich all holding on still. Looking very, very dominant on this map specifically. Things were looking pretty good for the Romanian roster at the start. I mean, we did see two double SS for quite a while. But unfortunately, those breaks throughout the middle of the map just cost them that one.
Yeah, I mean, this is what you'd expect from Australia playing DT here. Really, really solid performance. Doesn't even matter at this point. I mean, no one's really able to hold a combo. It's just MREC. Setona Diamond managed to recover quite well, but I mean, it's just not enough. So many breaks over and over for the rest of the team, and no one's really matching Emmerich on this one, and he is going to be the sole full combo, granting Australia a fourth point. They're now going to be on match point. And again, it's even on their pick after this as well, so they're in a very, very comfortable position here.
And Abusion with that supporting combo. I don't think it's going to be enough, though. It's looking like Romania is going to be taking this one away from Australia. Devache and Setona Diamond with the combo resets, but that is going to be Romania. Ooh, but Lacrease right at the end.
I think it's definitely enough.
It's...
Nice. So they're not going to get swept.
Oh, and a big drop from Team Australia. Milo Milkshake does fall. Lacrease with another reset. Vivace with another reset. But it's still two full combos from Eternum and Badu. Bringing Romania over the line here. Emmerich is doing all that he can. But the powerhouse from Eternum and Badu is going to pull Romania over this one. Badu does happen to find a miss at the end, but it's not going to be enough. It's right at the end.
Who misses this last stream? Okay, they all actually hit it. All right. Eternum yet again.
Yeah, this is Romania on the comeback right now. They are, you know, comeback driven right now.
Okay, they do not four way descending. There is no way. There's no way. Look at all this.
Okay, Eternum's gonna be the first one to break for Romania. Kind of to be expected on Hardrick, but oh my goodness, what is this performance from Romania?
Really? Just Eternum?
What is that? That is unreal. Bringing this one back for a tiebreaker. Mavs dropping that combo.
That's it.
And it looks like, yeah, we're going to see a tiebreaker. I mean, we talked about this match being the closest one. Badu happens to find a miss at the end, but it's right at the very end.
It won't matter. Romania actually pulled it off. From 0-4, they win 4 in a row. And it's time for the tiebreaker.
Wait a minute. It's not over yet.
Okay. We're just waiting so long for something to happen. Guys, something has happened.
Things are happening right now. Wake up, it's time. What is going on right now? Raze is the only full combo remaining for the Romanian side. Dummy has managed to hold on from that nervous miss. Emmerich still full comboing. Oh, a reset God. From Suffix. Oh my goodness, it's so close. Satana Diamond with a reset on that slider there.
Oh my God. I think there actually is enough time. There actually is enough time. Are they seriously doing this?
There is enough time. This is coming back very, very quickly. Is it going to happen? Raze is holding on quite strong. The crease with a bit of a combo reset there, dropping some accuracy. Oh my goodness, it's so close. It's so unbelievably close. Is it going to happen?
Oh my God.
The crease with a few misses at the end. Is this going to be the difference maker?
Oh my goodness.
4,000 points. What is that?
4,492 points in favor of Romania. Wow.
Unbelievable, man. That was so close. What a match. Yeah, this is the dominant force of Taiwan on double time right now. They are just looking so strong, you know, three quarters of the way through, and look at their accuracies and their combos right now. This is just dominance right here. You've got Villas doing all that they can along with Pogacz, you know, recovering that combo despite the early misses, but you know, the accuracy difference is just so huge here. And they are just running away. This is a 4.2 mil score so far, and we're not even done with the map yet, Dooms.
This is honestly a ridiculous score from Taiwan. Four-way full combo. What a play against anyone.
We talked about the surprise from them being in the loser bracket here. You know, this is a dominant team, and they are showing up right here, right now, with these double time performances. You know, very, very high combos, as well as that 4 mil score that we saw in the previous double time. Looking like it's going to be pretty much the similar result almost here. 3.8 mil. Czech Republic, ooh, unfortunately just having all sorts of combo resets happening across the board and just struggling a little bit in the accuracy department. But Taiwan are going to be taking that one 5-0.
Getting into match fitness, but when he's in full flow, he's one of the scariest players in the tournament scene. But he can't do it on his own. It's really close. Just man with some breaks there.
Oh, the lead is... This is pulling back very, very quickly. We're getting to right into the end section. Are we going to see it happen? Oh, a few breaks from the end. Oh my goodness, and it's just swaying back over to France at the end. My goodness.
Oh man, no one else broke though in Hong Kong. I think they're still fine. They should hold on to tiebreaker here, you think? Final streams.
Hong Kong has those multiple supporting combos. RLC does happen to break. F2X and Suagi still holding on against Okoro. Hifkill did happen to make that bit of a recovery going on. But it does look like they're going to secure this one. It did pull back a little tiny bit, but that is going to be the tiebreaker between these two teams, Hong Kong and France. We're going to see the second one, Dooms. Just Man happens to break as well, and that's pretty much going to seal France's fate at this point. It is going to be Hong Kong taking this one away 5-4 with what looks like a very convincing victory on this tiebreaker, with MCY4 and Sawagi just dominating on this.
MCY4 and Suwagi, the AIM tag team for Hong Kong, terrifying on these AIM maps, and this is an incredible show from these two. Oh, the slider from MCY4. The guy's done his job though. Suwagi's still going. Hong Kong had the edge in this one the entire time and only made their advantage count even more. France will not be getting their revenge just yet against Hong Kong. But what a match, though. And it's going to be Hong Kong who move on in the winner's bracket. 5-4. What a play from Suwagi.
Yeah, Suwagi just absolutely star performance right there on the tiebreaker. Pretty much what Hong Kong needed.
This is just like, are we going to see one of the best scores of the week at this point, more so than anything else? Because this map, as a result, quickly going to be a foreground conclusion. There is a late break from Apostol, so it is going to come back a little bit. But with Chickeny and Din still holding onto the FCs, this is not going to be a concern. And just a good first pick here for Russia. This is them knowing what their skill set is and taking a pretty clean point. It came back to 300k at the end, but was really never in doubt. Not working out the way Indonesia would have liked on their own first pick. Never want to go down that early break point, but that's exactly what's going to happen here.
Yeah, it was a bit unfortunate. I was looking at this and I was kind of seeing the roster they were putting in for this. And I noticed, you know, particularly Vitya and Vakman coming in for it. And of course, Testopivka as well, really strong on sort of, you know, the dense sort of map sets going into this ending. I mean, this is classic sort of Senya. Let's have the pause right towards the end of the map.
Yeah, they're all, I feel like their song, just they have that little break near the end. And that is going to be a late miss from Voprasov. Not going to get the four-way out of Russia. I believe the highest score I've seen so far, I think, is Taiwan, right? 4.6 million or something. So this is going to fall slightly short of that, but still a near 4.5 million score. Triple FC with
Russia. They were at the goal line. They could taste it, but they just couldn't pull it off just yet. Great score from Indonesia. Ryuta getting caught out by the slow slider there, though.
A slow slider away from a triple FC on this map. Oh, okay. There's gonna be no FCs. A slow slider. I don't even care. That ending doesn't count. That ending's stupid. Unironically, I think that the ending of this map is like too hard. It's 200k. Is there enough time to bring this back if they hold as they are right now?
It's Vitya that's gotta hold, and I would. Vitya is like the one person I'd trust to hold a combo at this stage. And it will go over as long as Vitya holds here.
Okay, here it comes into the ending. He doesn't hold. It's a break right near the end. The lead is only about 40,000 points, but I think it might just be enough for Indonesia to hold on into the end of the map, and they do by 23k. Vakman has to hold. Voprasov and Ciccone have to hold. Ro and Rexes need to maintain those full combos for Indonesia. But Rexes breaks. Now wait just a moment. There's a little bit of time left. I don't know if it's going to be enough, but there's a lot of score in the ending of these types of maps. It comes down.
I think they've got it.
It's going to be close and not enough. Again, though, 40,000 points.
Oh.
Wow. The awkward aim legend coming in. The clutchest performance for Russia this match. This is what they needed out of him. And he is delivering a full combo, and he is delivering them to the winner's bracket quarterfinals in what ended up being a much more contested match than it looked like it was going to be. Russia take the victory 5-3, stamping out that last second hope Indonesia had of forcing the tiebreaker.
Those two big combos on Philippines have to hold. They are looking good. Streams. K15 breaks. Enri holds on. 1K combo. And that's going to seal it. The Philippines going in for that Nomad 2 gambit, and it's working out really well.
Oh, that's got to feel good. Not many people can take a point off of Germany, but Philippines do it.
Final chorus and the outro to go. Plenty of time to pull it back. Just Smarty on the hard rock. Left for Germany.
They've got a hold here. They're gonna about to take the lead back. It's just a tiny section at the end. I think they got it. I think they're doing this. Yeah.
They have. Only just. It's a really close one, but that's a break point. Germany trying to play into the staring contest hasn't worked. Krilla and Okinamo though, holding all the way through that ending. Very nicely done. Very nicely done there from Germany. Taking the break point right back. Super duper close though. Looking scary there for Germany, but they're going to save it.
It's honestly really nice to see, despite Philippines barely losing this one, that on all of these picks, they can still fight. These are all really close. Okay.
No one breaks that. Wow. Oh. Zona Louise with the break, and that's not good for the Philippines. White Cat still going.
There's a Zoe flicker of hope for a second.
It would have made it really close. It might have been just short, but nevertheless, it was another competitive one, but Germany will bank their own pick. Nice 3 million. Nice FCs from White Cat and Henry. I think as we hand it back over now, though, slightly with Germany, not by much. That score lead is pretty big. There's not much of the map left.
Yeah, it's still going in Germany's favor. The map is pretty much over by now. Philippines certainly gave it their all. Honestly, that was a pretty good match from everyone involved. I mean, I think Philippines showed up as massive underdogs, and they showed that they're able to play.
Ooh, yes. That's what you like to see, baby. Bring it home. Bring it home. Ooh, Julio, going off. He doesn't care. Oh, never mind. Okay, he did miss, but it's over. I don't think there's enough time to recover.
Yeah, that hasn't gone well for you on that one. But that's okay.
Good one, guys. Very good.
At this stage, it's too far gone for Turkey on this one, but that's okay because
you love to see it.
Even Stevens now.
We don't comment on the oh my god shake, okay? We don't do that. If you know him, you know. Come on.
Nice break. Okay, all right. This is scary.
Yes! Oh, yes! Boy. Now it's gonna switch over. Oh, give me that! Yes! The tasty points! Oh no! Oh no! Okay, wait, they have no combos anyway. It's over. We got it. We're safe. We're good to go, guys. We're good to go. Don't worry about that. Don't you fucking worry about that. All right. We are back in the game. No issues. Okay, hold up. We do have more combos, boys. Don't worry about it. Hold it, please. It's possible Kirochi,
lose score on the very end if you're not careful though. That
I pray.
But
oh,
the way that Turkey needed, but not anymore.
No.
We're gonna go into the hard ending. If Kirochi can hold on through this, he's gonna be able to come back over.
Oh no, it's too late. Fuck. Oh no.
It's not
so close.
It's 20. All right. And Turkey,
no worries.
Holds.
Don't worry, guys. You pick another map, and then we win the tiebreaker. That's it.
I don't know.
It's that simple. Ooh, we almost missed. Yes! Okay, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, guys. Guys, don't worry about it. Drink some water. Let the nerves go. It's tiebreaker time. What an accuracy from... Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Yes. Look at that. I hope... they practiced the tiebreaker, or at the very least, they played it once, you know? I think we've done it, guys. Yes, Hironi just missed. Guys. Guys. It's done. It's been done. Kirochi. She does the thing. Yes. And Mikatsu. Misses! Yes, Kirochi, let's fucking go, Kirochi! Yes! That's a fucking GG, the wings! The wings of justice shine upon the Italian country! Oh my god! Yes! Yes! Oh, it's too easy! This is Kirochi right now.
FC the tiebreaker for good measure.
She doesn't care. She doesn't fucking care. She's just playing, like this. Stone-faced. She doesn't care. She doesn't give a shit, man. Yes.
Full combo.
Yes.
Tiebreaker. To lead Italy to victory.
Let's go, baby. Woo! I said it, man. I fucking said it. You weren't listening to me. We did it.
Scores from Arge and Julio. Italy got what it needed there.
Oh my goodness.
It's still pretty close.
Wow, man. That went south quickly. Yeah. That's another win for Ukraine.
Ooh.
3 points in a row.
Close until it wasn't.
Ouch.
I couldn't quite hold on to that advantage. Oh, it was so,
up until the very last second, it was Gunga close. And there we go. Is he really gonna finish this on a double S? Straight up flexing on those men.
It is.
Some of Spain's backing players are really struggling. Antonio doing everything he can. Raf GPOFC.
All right.
Doing something.
Okay, Dench.
Surely.
I see there what you're
is.
Doing.
There it is.
Jesus. Sweep plus double S plus ratio on Twitter. What a performance from Ukraine. I don't think there's much potential for it to switch over at this point because Yokespy has the big combo. So close though. That was not dominant at all.
The hardest part of the map now, and there's not too much to break on at the ending here.
Melver good start, good start. Off to a very good start for Team Norway. GN! Well. Old man carrying
exactly
his team. You love
right
to see it, man. This is proof that even if you're 40 years old, you can still play Osu and succeed. Let that be an inspiration for all of you. He's hitting the bursts, you know, no double tapping or anything. He's in the zone. Only 26? Dude, in Osu years, 26 is like old man. People call me old, I'm 22. So what does that make GN? This was really unexpected, man. I didn't think Norway was gonna sweep. I knew they were gonna win, because that's my prediction, but I thought at the very least Chile would get one or a couple points. I can't really recall what my prediction was, but it was something along those lines. Damn.
If you've made it through the rest of this map, you're gonna make
Nindre camping Winzy, the new generation coming in.
And into the
ah, yes, you love to see it, man. You do. Is Maliszewski gonna send it? Bring it home for the country, for Poland? Polska Gurum?
Yeah,
that's it. Ah, man, Maliszewski, 99.8. Nahus is going insane, though. He's going very, very good. He's doing super well. Just missing right at the end. And then Maliszewski takes it home with another FC. Two in a row, baby. I think this is like third Maliszewski FC thus far. So three FCs out of three. Man, Nahus is so good. So underrated in the grand scheme of things. Surely Maliszewski is the shining star of this match thus far. As I think this is fourth FC at this point. But Nahus...
Four
going off. Can
no
Korean Maluko do this?
It's
over.
You can't.
That's a GG right there. The difference is too big
it.
Now. Maliszewski.
No way. What do you do?
Maliszewski just won't miss.
Like, there's literally like two or three teams in the tournament that can like consistently combat.
Maliszewski literally just FC'd five maps out of five.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Right. Have it.
What do you do against that?
Oh my god.
What do you do against that?
Against
I gotta say though, big props to Suti. That egg is nuts.
Rudge find a reset. That score's not gonna go anywhere.
God damn.
They're holding on. The two FCs.
There's not enough time though.
Drop, but it's very late into the map now. It's coming in. Canada are closing in.
Well played, UK. Jesus Christ.
They do not.
1.7 maybe there was enough time. Jesus, man. Never mind. What the fuck am I witnessing? An 8-way FC? No, Rad J. No.
Oh, that's
fucking
tragic.
Way, man. Right before the break.
Unbelievable. What am I looking at?
That is insane.
That's gonna feel so bad. Oh no!
God.
I mean, to be fair, that's Canada's peak, so I would expect them to do super well. Sutinator is just on fire right now. Is this like the third FC? Okay, like the previous one wasn't an FC, one slider break, but whatever, man. Like 900k plus, that's basically an FC.
Great performance here from Canada on this.
Ooh, she makes it look so easy. Are they gonna do it? Are they gonna have the double FC?
Battle Canada today. It is a good showing though. And they did manage to take a point off Canada.
And yes.
But it's not enough.
GG. That's very good actually. 3.2 million team score on a map like this.
Doesn't really
that's good, man. That's good.
How close some of the maps were, but no
well done.
Canada
well done, Team Canada. You've done the thing.
Bit too much on most of the maps today.
And UK is going to Brazil.